Hey guys, Everything Apple Pro here. It's just chaos. I don't think I've ever seen something like this before. iOS 14, an early development build has leaked. We have a glimpse into the future at Apple's upcoming products. WatchOS 7 and iOS 14 features have been spilled. This is unprecedented. Let's get into it. I'd like to remind you, we're still running our S20 Ultra giveaway, so just a few more days for that. We've been working on this other video when out of nowhere, 9to5Mac dropped a bombshell today. They have their hands on iOS 14. It's unclear how, but apparently there was a build floating around for sale. Maybe 9to5Mac got their hands on it, maybe someone else did. And from this beta, 9to5Mac has gleaned several upcoming products, starting with this glyph. Much like the AirPods Pro, which leaked in this very similar glyph format, we now have our first look at Apple's upcoming over-ear high-end studio headphones. And 9to5Mac was able to obtain a light and dark mode version of this glyph, which could possibly mean we'll be seeing two colors of these Apple over-ear headphones, a black or space gray version and a white or silvery look. And as for the release and production, it'd likely be in September. iOS 14 is slated for release, full release in September. We'll be seeing beta 1 in June. So this is probably a very early sneak peek of what Apple has cooking. Unfortunately, we don't have a design for you. All of these leaks just dropped today, so we haven't had time to work on it, but we'll get there. Okay, and digging deeper, 9to5Mac found that Apple is looking to completely overhaul the iPadOS experience on iPadOS 14, starting with the cursors. Now Apple is improving support for the cursors, and there will actually be a dynamic cursor. So you'll be able to select between different types depending on what you're doing. If you're clicking on a link, if you're editing text, you might be seeing a different cursor. They're calling it sophisticated mouse control. And this would be building on top of iPadOS 13, which added the mouse unofficially in the accessibility settings. This would be fully embracing the mouse on the iPad. Now, unlike on the Mac, the mouse would disappear after a few seconds. And this is the bridge. This is how Apple introduces the mouse on the iPad. So the mouse will be disappearing after a few seconds, reintroducing the touch screen so you can easily manipulate it. Once you use your mouse again, then it will reappear and you can use it like a computer. Actually, very genius thinking here and a very nice in-between between the iPad and tablet and the desktop computer. And moving on, Apple will be adding a gesture taken straight from the Mac. Tap with two fingers to right click. Now, where would you be using this? The new trackpad on the new Smart Keyboard. So yes, Apple is officially adding a trackpad to the Smart Keyboard. Even further evidence of this has been found in the latest iOS 14 beta, and Apple will be bringing this keyboard to multiple iPads. So not just one, the Pros, but Apple will likely be expanding it with the trackpad support to the 10.2-inch iPad. This is huge. This would fundamentally change the way your iPad deals with external displays. You'd actually theoretically be able to interact with them, change the windows, just do things on an external display, go back to yours, touch things, use a mouse. It would enable a whole new level of power on the iPad Pros. And as Steve Troughton Smith puts it, it finally brings the iPad into the modern age. Everything is coming together so nicely for iPadOS and the new iPad hardware. And further digging has revealed Apple's intentions for the Apple Watch Series 6, as well as WatchOS 7. Starting with a new feature for blood oxygen monitoring. It's unclear if this would be available on older hardware, if you need any additional sensors for it, but theoretically older watches should be able to do it. Knowing Apple though, they'll make it exclusive to the newer Apple Watches. It's very similar to the high heart rate notifications on the Apple Watch. If it drops below 80, if you know anything about these measurements, you'll get a notification. If it drops even further, it'll be this life or death type notification. And taking that even further, Apple will be upgrading the electrocardiogram on the Apple Watch Series 6. Currently, there's a fault between 100 and 120 beats per minute. It's not a very accurate reading. The Series 6 will fix that with improved ECG hardware. So the Apple Watch Series 6 will be a complete hardware overhaul. We've previously heard it'll be more water resistant, even faster with an upgraded chip finally, not recycled like the Series 5. And with the Apple Watch catching up, the competition is almost at Apple's level of the Apple Watch. Apple really wants to stand out right now. By the way, about that Apple Watch, just a complete and blatant ripoff of Apple's current Apple Watch hardware. No digital crown, but still very similar from all angles. The one thing I do like about it is the curved displays on all edges, and the OLED inside wraps around more than the current Apple Watch. Otherwise, just a shameless ripoff. 9to5Mac also found that Apple will be introducing three new Apple Watch faces on watchOS 7. Apple is also introducing a new feature, Share Your Face, or you can finally, using the iPhone app, share your current Apple Watch setup with other users and have them share theirs with you. And what's interesting about this sharing feature is that it'll be an actual file that you can then open and preview in the Files app and airdrop to other users. And 9to5Mac speculates that this could open up the doors for third-party Apple Watch faces, which has long been a requested feature. And a watch face Apple is introducing in particular is the Infograph Pro, which will be including a tachymeter, which is a way to measure speed and distance based on travel time. It's a feature that many analog smartwatches have, further showing you that Apple is pulling inspiration from the analog watch market for the Apple Watch. Also, Apple will be allowing you to use shared photo albums to create watch faces between several people. So several people will be able to contribute to a folder, and then from that, you can make various watch faces and share them with everyone immediately. And apparently, Apple is making extensive changes to watchOS 7, making it more kid-friendly, starting with a feature 9to5Mac is calling Parent iPhone Kid Watch, where from one iPhone, you can sync and pair to multiple Apple Watches. It's a very clever way to introduce your child to the health world without them needing to have an iPhone, so you can manage it for them from yours. Taking that child-proofing even further, there's a new feature called School Time, where parents will be able to manage the complications and the actions that can be performed on the Apple Watch during certain time periods. And 9to5Mac confirms that sleep tracking is finally happening. Apple will be including it with the upcoming watchOS 7. Unclear if it's only for newer iPhones, but theoretically, older ones should be able to support it as well. And they add that you'll be able to set your sleep goal in the health app, and that on the Apple Watch and possibly on the iPhone, Apple will be adding control center toggles for this new sleep mode and the noise detection feature. So you'll be able to quickly enable those on your Apple Watch or possibly even the iPhone. And starting with watchOS 7, Apple will be making the Apple Watch even more independent from the iPhone as the fundamental architecture of certain apps is changing. The Apple Watch will be more capable to handle these apps without the iPhone. Also in older but relatable news, it appears that Apple is experimenting with putting Touch ID into the digital crown on the Apple Watch series. This is a patent, but definitely shows you that the future of the Apple Watch is more secure as Apple is considering adding that to the side of the Apple Watch. It's possible though that this feature won't be coming to the crown, but instead on a gesture-based pad on the side of the Apple Watch. A new patent also shows that Apple is looking into replacing it with gesture-based commands. Also regarding the redesigned multitasking pane we saw in iOS 14 from Ben Geskin, that actually is real. Apparently the kernel from that build matches up to the leaked development build from December 2019. And as supporting evidence, it's very likely, if this is in the final build, that this is the new app switcher look on iOS 14. You'll be able to actually swipe apps down to lock them, potentially preventing them from getting closed or refreshed. Moving on to iPhone stuff. First, a very optimistic report from Barron's. They're claiming the iPhone 12 Pro will trigger the long-awaited iPhone supercycle, claiming that up to 350 million iPhone users are primed to upgrade for Apple's 5G iPhone, and it'll trigger the stock to go up to $400. Absolutely crazy. It's in the realm of possibility, but those numbers, man, with iPhone sales declining, that just seems unrealistic. And Barron's mentions that the outbreak, of course, is an impediment, but eventually Apple will get past it. By the way, want to talk about that? Absolute chaos. Things are not looking good for Apple. Products getting delayed, canceled, pushed back, events not happening. What's going on there? So first and foremost, it's very likely that we won't even be seeing a March event. It's unclear what Apple will be doing with the products they're supposed to be announcing in the March event, but it's very likely that Apple will be pushing those back until WWDC, or maybe we'll see them getting lumped together with the iPhone event in September. It's also very possible Apple could still do a press release, but as of now, holding a physical event for their March release would be pretty irresponsible on Apple's end. And seeing just how bad it is out there, it's very possible Apple will cancel WWDC as well, not only because of the virus, but also because everything just leaked. So, just kidding. Apple could hold a small briefing for a select few amount of journalists. Also, they could do an online streaming event, but it's very unlikely we'll be seeing physical events. A very good call on Tim Cook's end is allowing his employees to stay at home instead of having to come into the office and mingle this coming week. A shocking statistic is that their sales fell 60% in February compared to February of 2019. It's clear that Apple's priorities have shifted, number one, to keeping their employees safe instead of releasing products at risk and fixing their production lines, of course. And where does that leave the new iPad Pros? possible that Apple will still be releasing them end of March, according to Ben Geskin. Digitimes is also reporting that the new AirPod Pro Lights will be starting production in early second quarter. So Apple is still working on those, trying to get them to market. The timing of all of these products, very difficult to say when they'll be dropping, how they'll be dropping, but Apple's plans have certainly been altered. And one last thing I'd like to show you, real Android running on the iPhone. Android 10 has been ported to the iPhone 7, 7 Plus, and iPod Touch. And this is using the new Checkrain boot ROM exploit made by the Corellium team, the same people that actually released the original Android on iPhone port on the 2G and 3G. It's very bare right now. Many things aren't working. Internet connection is working, Bluetooth working, very buggy, but they'll fix it. They'll get there. It's just interesting to see how this starts. Real Android is working on the iPhone once again. That's just crazy. There it is, guys. Latest happenings, just crazy. The chaos that's going on right now. A lot more coming, guys. Peace.